Hello everybody, my name is Walter and today I want to show you how I can build my notebook 7x7 double door. You can see right in front of you. As you can see, it looks like a simple 7x7 vault door, which also looks the same from the back side and has a single notebook at the very center of it. And if I right click on that, besides of some noise, it also triggers the door to open and after a certain amount of time automatically close again, as you can see here. This door is completely spam-proof, by the way, so there's no danger of accidentally destroying the door, and how long it stays open can be easily adjusted through the amount of items inside of those hoppers on the side here. 5 items would mean that the door closes immediately after it has opened completely, and any additional item in here means an additional 4 ticks or 4/10 of a second of delay in between. And that's pretty much how the door here works. Now let's talk about the sizes. So it's a total of 7 blocks long, 9 blocks if you count the walls, 17 blocks wide, and 16 blocks high, so actually pretty compact. And now for the resources. I haven't counted towards those the glowstone blocks here, since they are just there to light up this thing and keep mobs from spawning, but not really needed for the thing to work. And with that, let's get to the resources themselves. So of course some building blocks, then 13 slabs, 49 obsidian blocks, 45 slime blocks, 112 redstone dust, 18 redstone torches, 30 redstone repeaters, 7 comparators, 35 observers, 41 normal pistons, 68 sticky pistons, a single note block, 2 droppers, 14 hoppers, a single lever, although during the building process you are gonna need a second one, and then finally 14 eggs or another item with a stack size of 16. And that's pretty much all you're gonna need, so let's quickly show how to build this door here. Okay, so the first step is marking the center of the door with a dropper facing downwards right at the floor level. Then below that we need another hopper facing upwards this time. So basically we have 2 hoppers facing each other, like so. Then we need a block diagonally there and a comparator towards the right side, taking an output from the lower hopper, dropper. Then this runs into a full block with a torch on the side of that. Then another torch below here. Then need another block there with a repeater on one tick in this direction. Block behind it. Then we go down with 2 more blocks. Place a torch there, then some redstone dust in there. Then let's go and first place 3 blocks like this here, then a 4th one raised there. Next let's grab a comparator, place it there, some redstone dust right there. Then a torch here and a sticky piston there, followed by a foot block in there. Then we mirror this more or less with a 2 wide gap in between, so the 4 blocks as you can see here. Then a torch right there, followed by a sticky piston, some redstone dust, and a comparator there. Then in between the 2 comparators we need 2 hoppers facing each other like so, and in there we need 11 items. Now the EFO clock here will be running. Then let's place a comparator on top of this block, running into another full block. Then behind that we need another 2 hoppers facing each other like this here. Then a block up there with another torch on the side of that one. Then let's place in some items in here. The minimum amount is 5 items, but then the door will open and then at once close, even before you can get through this. Something around 15 or 14 blocks here is a good amount of time. Each item represents a 4 tick or 4/10 of a second delay. Anyway, let's quickly continue on. First we need another 3 blocks there, followed by 2 upside down snaps there, then another block on this side. Let's put down some redstone dust on top of these blocks here. Then a block there with a torch on the side of it, block on top and redstone on this side. Then another block here with a torch on this side of it and a block on top of that one. Then while we're here, let's actually put another 2 blocks here and some redstone dust on top. Following that, grab a lever and place it on the side of this block here, then turn that on. This will deactivate the automatic reset. Then with that done, let's place a single item in the bottom dropper there. Then after that, let's go and first start with a block down there. with a repeat in this direction, one tick, running into a full block, then a lower block with some redstone dust on top. Below that we need a normal piston followed by a row of 6 normal blocks. Then on top of that we need 5 observers, followed by 3 normal blocks. Put down 2 normal pistons here and 3 sticky pistons there. Then let's place another block here with some redstone dust on top, run this into an obsidian block. Then diagonally there we need another block with a repeater on 2 ticks, running into a full block. Then below that we need another 2 blocks like so. Then let's go to the outside and place another 4 blocks here and a 5th one raised there. Put down redstone dust on top of these blocks. Then while we're down here, let's actually place an obsidian server there. And here, with a sticky piston in between, like this here, then let's grab another 2 sticky pistons, place them there, followed by 3 normal pistons there. Finally, let's place down 2 slime blocks here, and then let's quickly move this to the back half. Now add one more block here, followed by another observer, block and sticky piston, same on the opposite side of course. Then let's quickly go and first place on the front half another block right there with a repeat on 4 ticks in this direction, running into a full block, then a lowered block. Then to this side another block, raised block, lowered block, inwards another lowered block, then remove this one here. Let's place some redstone dust on top of those blocks, a torch on top of this one here. Then need another 2 blocks here with a repeat on 1 tick and on 4 ticks, running into a full block. Then let's place 2 sticky pistons there, followed by 4 slime blocks, like so. Next we need a few hoppers, place 2 like that here, then put redstone dust on top of them, another hopper right there, followed by an observer on top of this slime block, running into the hopper at the moment, a repeater on 2 ticks there, running into a full block, then grab some half steps, place them towards front and back, as you can see there. Then on top of that we need repeaters on 4 ticks each, running into full blocks, with a lowered block following that, redstone dust on top of that, then 2 lowered blocks here, some redstone dust there and a repeater on 1 tick there, and below that we need a normal piston which should be at 1 wide gap away from the blocks down there. And the same we need on this side, so the lowered block with redstone dust, then the 2 more lowered blocks, redstone dust and the repeat on 1 tick, and the observer, normal piston right there. Then grab some slime blocks, place 2 up there, then another 2 across, and the same here. And that should be pretty much the entire floor done. Which leaves us with filling in the actual floor itself. For that, let's start here on the left side with a T-shape of obsidian blocks, like so. Then on the right side we essentially follow this inner edge of the slime blocks with 6 obsidian blocks in total, as you can see here. Then you can fill in the rest of the floor with normal blocks, and after that it's time to start building the right side. So now for the right side, let's start in this corner with a torch on top of this block, then block on top and to the side, redstone dust there, then another 2 sticky pistons, as you can see there. Put a torch on the side of this block, then we need another 2 hoppers facing each other, like that here. Then place down 3 blocks like so, put down 2 comparators here and a third one in subtract mode there. Block behind that and in front of it, then lower here another block, and another 2 obsidian blocks going down like so, put down 3 redstone dust there, torch on top of this block, another block here with a repeat on 3 ticks in this direction, running into a full block, then to this side a repeat on 1 tick, running into another full block, then full block to the back, followed by an upside down snap in the opposite direction, put down 3 redstone dust like so, then grab 4 normal pistons and place them going up here. Next grab some sticky pistons, place 3 in a column like so. Then put down 3 slime blocks, an observer on top of it, then a sticky piston right there. Next grab a normal piston, place it in this direction. Then we need to block up and down here. Put down redstone dust on top of those three blocks. Next, let's go to this corner here. First, place an observer here. Then, diagonally to that, we need a obsidian block. Put down two redstone dust, as you can see here. Then, put down a torch on top of this block. Lock to this side and on top. Redstone dust there. Then, two sticky pistons like so. Now, we need a lever on the side of this block to redirect this wire there. Then, let's go and first place the block up here, then we go up diagonally until we are on top of this normal piston there, put down some redstone dust to connect the entire thing. Then on this side here we need another block lowered with a repeater on one tick in this direction, running into a full block. Then another full block to this side. Then an upside down slab once more in this direction, three redstone dust. And our four normal pistons, as you can see here. Then another two normal pistons there and there. Following that, grab some slime blocks, place two like so, then another two on top of that. Next, grab another two observers, place them facing down in front of the slime blocks. Then to the face of that, we need a node block. Following that, let's go up here. First, start with a double piston extender starting right next to the half steps there. Then on top of those we need observers facing downwards like so. Then at the front we need hoppers and at the back we need again half steps. Next, let's go down and first place two repeaters on two ticks each there. Then redstone dust on top of the blocks, as you can see here. Then cut off the wire in those positions. Next, grab a sticky piston, place it here, and another one right there. Followed by four slime blocks going down here and here. Then let's go and place an up and down of blocks, as you can see here. Put redstone dust on top of all these blocks here. Then essentially start with a line of blocks connecting this with this line down there. And then put and place some redstone dust all the way up here. And with that done, it's time to start filling in the actual wall. For that, let's start at the bottom here with a block of obsidian right below the observer there. Then we need two to each side here. Then on top we need one block there. Then another two like so. And then last a few like this. And then the rest can be filled in with normal blocks. And it should end up looking similar to this here. Then let's quickly go to the back here and first place 14x inside of this hopper here. The transfer should stop at 7x. And with that we can now finally give the test run. So simply flick the lever off here, wait until the entire thing has closed. Then let's turn the lever on again for now. Flick the node block and then the entire thing here should open once more, which means now it's time to start building the left side here. Okay, so now for the left side, let's start with a block on top of this torch there, then a raised block to this side, a block to this side of that, and another raised block here. Three redstone dust and a torch on the side and top of this block. And all following steps for the rest of the door can be mirrored from front to back, so let's start at the front half here. First we need three blocks front and side of the torches like so. Then put some redstone dust here and a repeater on two ticks there, running into a full block. Then two blocks here, some redstone dust there and another repeater on four ticks in this direction. Then a block here with some redstone dust on top. Then two more blocks there. An obsidian block right there. Then grab another torch, place it here with an observer in this direction, running into a sticky piston. Then up here a double piston extender with some slime in the front of it, Normal piston, right there. Then let's quickly mirror this. After that, grab another slab, place it upside down, diagonally to this block here. Then diagonally to that, we need another hopper, and diagonally to that one, another hopper, as you can see here. Then put redstone dust on top of those blocks here. Grab an observer, place it right next to the hopper facing downwards. On top of that, we need a repeater in this direction on two ticks. Then a block there, another block here with some redstone dust, and another repeater on two ticks running into a full block. Then again an observer facing downwards here. Put down two redstone dust, as you can see there. Then a full block below the observer. And with a one high gap, we need another upside down slab, again with some redstone dust on top. Then grab two normal pistons, place them like so, and four sticky pistons like so. Then let's go down here, place another two sticky pistons there, below that another sticky piston, and then slime blocks to the face of it. And now let's quickly mirror this once more. And with that, this side is also pretty much finished. Now let's quickly start filling in the wall. Again, we start with the obsidian blocks on the inner edges of where the slime blocks are moving later on. And from here on, the rest can be once more filled in with normal blocks, and after that, it's time to start building the top part. Now for the top part, similar to the left side, I will just show you how to build the front half and then mirror during the cuts. But anyway, let's start with an upside down slab right here on the left side, followed by two raised blocks here, then another raised block, lowered block, and two obsidian blocks. Then let's place another block there, put down redstone dust on top of these blocks here. Then we need another upside down half slab right there, followed by two blocks right there. Redstone dust there, then a repeater on four ticks here, and two ticks there, and two ticks down there. Then put a obsidian block in front of this redstone wire there. On this side, we need first a full block up there, then an obsidian block lowered with some redstone dust on top. Place a torch here, an observer looking at it on top, then another observer in this direction, full block to the face of that, then full block there, with another repeater on two ticks there, an observer looking at it with a full block to the face. Then let's go and first grab two sticky pistons and place them in here. Then a double piston extender there and another sticky piston to the side of that. Another 2x2 of slime blocks, as you can see here. Then grab two normal pistons, place them here, another two normal pistons there, followed by some sticky pistons lowered like this here. Then grab three blocks, place them here, redstone dust on top, and another observer right there. And that's pretty much the entire circuitry. Now let's quickly mirror this. And after that, let's fill in the actual ceiling. For that, let's start with some obsidian blocks again on the inner edge of the slime blocks. On the right side, we already did this indirectly while building the circuitry. And with that, we can now start filling in the rest with normal blocks. And it should end up looking similar to this here. And with that, it's finally time to give the entire door a test run. So let's remove the lever now. Let's see if it closes. And that's what we want to see. And then let's simply click the node block. And after a certain amount of time, the entire thing should start to close again. And with that, the door is pretty much finished, which leaves us with just filling in the front and back wall, and of course a bit of the floor. And voila! So as you can see, I added in the walls, the floor, and also a bit of glowstone to keep the entire thing lit up and mobs from spawning. And with that, we have finally reached the end of this tutorial about my node block 7x7 double volt door. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya!